balance in this. The clarity on it's super clear. Let's see. If you wanted to sharpen it more, what I use is I use Sharpen, Smart Sharpen. If anything, I mean, you really don't need much. Do 1px here. I mean, you don't need a whole lot. These are very clear, so just a little bit, nothing much. Again, you probably don't need them. So for this, the hair right here, I would just use the patch tool. And try to clear that off of her lip. You want to keep the flowers on there, the little petals, you can, or you can take them off. I'd use the same tool if I were taking them off. Honestly, they kind of distract, so I would probably take them off. It's just like my blanket. I have a quilt like this. It's really cute, I love it. And you can fine tune if you see some yellow in there. So with my patch tool, I use Structure 3 up here with Content Aware. And then I always try to stay on the same line or pull from an area I want to pull the content from. So there, not so distracting. If you want to clear out some of the flyaways, you can. I kind of like them. Depends on, I guess, the family you're photographing. Girls are super cute. So for me, I use Greater Than Gatsby a lot. They're my favorite actions. So I always start with the Michelangelo foundation. It is a lush, rich coloring. I'll run that through. Doesn't work on everyone. Sometimes I'll pick different ones depending on the picture. So here I'm not really looking at skin tones. It darkened their skin tone a little bit. I'll probably mask that off. The background looks great though, so that's what I'm looking for when I do the base. So I'm going to use my black soft brush, and I'm going to go over their skin. It's currently at 21% opacity. We'll see how that goes, if it needs more. Back that up a little bit. I like the nice golden color in the background. questioning if I would keep the tree or if I'd remove it. If I removed it, I would mirror this side over here and just put it over there. The little limb it looks like is here. I might remove that. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so the hair on her face here, I would probably break out frequency separation. So that's something I'm going to do last. Looks like maybe she's got a little scratch here. Let me just patch that real quick. And that hair right there sticks out and then maybe it. Looks like there is a hair in her eye. You can see it on the pixel level. It's just, a lot of people aren't going to pick up on it. I tend to see it. I don't know why I see it. There are these tiny little hairs from her sister all in her face. So some we can fix without frequency separation. Some's going to need frequency separation, but keep it looking natural. I think that's the best I can do for that. Okay. So now with Painterly, it has an airbrush smoother. I'm going to run that over their face. It will blur out a little bit of the hair on her face. We'll see how that looks. I never leave it at 100% opacity. I always reduce it once I do it. Let's start at 100. I love the porcelain look to skin tones, especially in children. I would stay away from creases, things like that, eyelashes. Looks like she might have a little scratch up there that I'm going to go back and fix. And that hair right there that I can fix. And one over her eye as well. These curls are too cute. Looks like I need to plug in my laptop. Before, after. So here I'm going to pull it down to about 60%. Grab my cord. Okay. Now let's brighten up their skin a little bit. Again, Painterly, I have both, Painterly 1 and 2. I got the full bundle. Use them both differently. Get the skin, for kids especially. Skin light. Just going to lighten them up a little bit. Sometimes I'll use skin glow. It just depends. Since it's sunset behind them, I really don't want to use a glow. So I'm going to just lighten it. It's going to be very dramatic, but we're going to go back and reduce it. Stay away from the edges because you want that shadowing. I do take it over the eyes and the eyebrows. I reduce it to about 20%. So as you can see on her, it brings her just a little bit more lightness. Her sister's already lighter, so I'm going to drop her down. I brush down to about 50. Same thing. Eyes, eyebrows, everything but the edges. Honestly, I can do the lips too. I'm going to reduce this a little bit more. Sometimes it's just a subtle little light you want, not a whole lot. There we go. I'm not trying to wash them out. Okay, one of the other I use is the Innocence 2 bundle, which has Innocence Retouch. I use this on every single one of my photos. The skin tones need a little punch. I'll add it. I think there's this bit here, but let's just take a look. Almond on this girl. And I'll use Fresh on her because she's got a little bit of a lighter skin tone. Barely anything. You don't really want. I don't want it to look fake. And for her sister. And then for the eyes, I pull all of these. Zoom in. Start with your base. Always keep my brush at 100, and then I reduce the opacity of the action. subtle cleanness there. Brightens it up just a bit. Okay, then we move up to enhance brightness. This is for the iris area. I do little zigzags. Trying to stay away from the edge because we want that rim to be darker and away from the pupil in the middle. So it's just a little bit of extra light in the eyes. Okay, dark rim. I do this last. So then you got your sharp white. All it's going to do is sharpen your eyes. I only put on, excuse me, I'm thinking soft sharpen. Only put this on pupil area. Try to stay away from the whites. If you hit the whites, you just go back over it with a black brush. Just going to make sure your clarity is really popping right there in the eye. Now, back to the shape light. This goes in your thickers, so you have these lights up here. I'm just going to run it over those. Just going to add that brightness to it. Then minimize redness on the whites, just in case, especially with them having brown eyes. You don't want to take it over the pupil. See how there's some redness there, it'll just take that out. Okay, purify. I don't use this always, but it's just going to lighten your whites in areas. This side's already really bright. I'm going to try to balance it. I typically pull the opacity down on this one. I'll zoom out and look at it. I don't want them to look, but so see how it brightens them. Just so that they're softer. So that's better. And then the lash darkening, thickening, it's just going to give you a little burn on the lashes. I'll use my light brush. Again, I pull this down quite a bit. I just want it to subtly darken them. She's got some long lashes. Beautiful. Oh, so this is the eyes. I'm going to duplicate my base. Hide the original, and then I'm going to merge. I do this just so I can compare the two, where they were, where it went, and look and see how natural it is. I think it looks great. Their eyes shine, they pop. I think it looks good. I'm going to keep it. And then move on. attached to. It's a lot of attention to detail, it really is. I know a lot of people do things differently than me. Some people want their customers or clients to say, hey, can you fix this? Can you do that? I'd rather just do it ahead of time and not have them ask. You know, if they don't know that there's a hair going across their kid's eye to begin with, then I don't have to worry about it. I don't typically do these in big sections. It's always really small ones. That way you get an accurate clone or patch. Next thing I do is I do a teeth whitener, but I do it very subtly, just enough so that it looks natural, but a lot of the time teeth, especially if they're pearly whites, will pick up color cast from the surroundings. I know as I brush this on, it looks really fake. That's not where I'm going to leave it. I'm going to bring this down to about 15%. Just enough that it pops just a little bit. You can see the green that her teeth picked up in the surroundings, so I'll just take it off a little bit for a more natural smile. I'm going to make the background pop a little bit. Kelsey Freeman has some actions. I don't really personally, not that I don't like them, I just don't use them. All of these special ones I don't use. I like to use, sometimes I'll use the light add-on for little sun pops here and there. But her extras that she has are what I use. Her add some depth. Love it. So I'm going to add some depth. It's for the background, it's not for the subject. And then I'm going to mask it off with the subject. Bless you. So I'm going to take it up to the edge of the hair so that the little flyaways and stuff will blend in with that background. And it'll keep that sun-kissed look to it. So as you can see, it darkens the background quite a bit, but I'm going to reduce that too. I just want to add that little pop of depth. It just gives it just a little bit more depth. Merge those. And she has a color pop. Basically, it increases vibrancy. I'm going to do that everywhere, and I'm going to mask it off the skin. clothes pop, everything pops. I just don't want their skin to look orangey. And next is the contrast pop. So that's going to really make their skin and everything pop out. It's going to give your background a nice boost. The more I look at this, the more I think I am going to get rid of this tree and stuff. I'll do that last. Okay, so there's your pop of your skin, your color. I do think I might go in and add a little bit of that skin glow. And paint away, so let's try the skin glow. Let's see how it looks. Does it look right? I'll take it off. Yeah. Just a nice little glow there, so we're going to keep it. And I do think I'm going to bring the lips out just a little bit, so I'm going to go back to my Innocence collection. Soft pink. I'm not going to leave it this way. I always stay at 100% so I can see what I'm doing. Put it on the gums a little bit because I want to bring the colors out. Let me show you this. I put just a smidge on the cheeks. Again, not going to leave it like this. See, that would look ridiculous if I did. Just bring it down to about 10%. Just so you have this nice little barely blush color on their cheeks and their lips pop just a little bit more. Kind of more color to them instead of it being so, I don't want to say drab, but that's the word that comes to mind. Like a barely blush. Okay, here we go. Again, when I edit, I try to keep it natural. I don't want it to look fake. Honestly, this hair right here doesn't bother me that much, so I am not going to use frequency separation because that would add probably 30 more minutes to this tutorial. But there you go. And it has a before and after here. Of a porcelain look, which is what I go for, but not like fake porcelain. So their skin's lightened and they got a nice little color to their cheeks. So if you look at it full. Let's see if I can get. I've had some issues with my free transform, so I'm going to see if I can get it to flip for me sometime. I did an update, now it flips upside down, yeah, that's not going to work. Okay. I can just flip it, and I'm going to mask. Control-I fills that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a white brush, and I'm going to mirror that background on this side. Only in the areas that I'm going to get rid of. I use a smaller brush, I can get in closer to her hair and kind of blend that a little bit better. And then I found the head, so can't go right through and make it blend. Okay, here we have that. Let's see, typically I get paint really too. Go down to the bottom. They have all these nice beignets. Some people like beignets, some don't. I think if you ever do it with just a black beignet, it looks nasty, but I don't always use that. So this is a nice golden color. Let's start with a depth one and see what that looks like. So here I'm looking at the background and surrounding. And then maybe the net. So I play with them. I don't get afraid of mixing them. And then I am going to mask it off with the girls. What I do is I blend the three together. It's not a huge difference, just a little bit. I'm going to blend, take it off of their skin. So hit the mask layer with a black soft brush, 100%. Use to get off their skin. I'm not so worried about their hair. Shouldn't hit their clothes really, but I'll be all right. And then I always check this. I always hit my color balance. Zoom in first. Color balance and just check. So is it a little too pink on their skin? Maybe, so I'll move it just a smidge. If it's too yellow, I'll move it a smidge that way. That would be a good thing. If it were too green, I'd move to magenta. If it's too magenta, move to green just a little. It was good, so I don't need those. I'm just going to change them. Last thing is I'm going to run a contrast one last time. Levels. Middle one, just a little. Hang it over the skin. ever question anything, I duplicate and I merge so that I can look at the difference. I like it lightened up like that. And I'll call that one done. Okay, so we got the finished and the before. Again, gorgeous picture. Great clarity. Lovely girls.